Good morning, everybody, and welcome to Church From Your Couch. This morning, I would like to welcome you all to our special family service. As you all know, during the month of June, we usually have a special family service at the church, after which we go to the beach for a church picnic. Now, unfortunately, because of COVID-19, we can't do that this year. However, we still have something very special planned for our service this morning. I would firstly like to thank Mark for putting our service together. And then, as we would usually celebrate our young people during this service, I would like to say a huge big thank you to every single child and young person who attends the West Kirk and Paul Beth Harwood Church, as well as the South African Church here in Scotland. Thank you for coming to church so regularly and making our churches the special places they are. Can I also say a huge, huge big thank you to all the young people who are participating in today's service. You are superstars. Thank you also to all the volunteers involved in teaching the young people in our churches about the Word of God. So thank you very much to Lorna and all her helpers at the Sunday Club, to Sandra and all her helpers at the Jam Club, to Nick for running the youth group, and to Alison for running Teen Time, and everybody who helped you with this too. You are all amazing, and I thank God that He works through all of you in such a special way here in our church. Let us now start our service in the name of God with our call to worship. And this morning, our call to worship is taken from the Bible, from Psalm 119, verse 9, where we read, "How can a young person keep his or her way pure? By living according to the word of God." Amen.
Let us now come before God in prayer. Let us pray. Lord God Almighty, to you be honour and praise forever. Thank you that we can be gathered in your name now, Father, together in spirit. You have called us to be your children. Thank you for trusting us with this privilege. Thank you for empowering us in the ways of service. Thank you for giving us courage when we are scared. Thank you for giving your strength when we are vulnerable. Thank you for knowing us, loving us, and enhancing our lives. Please forgive us for these times when we have forgotten to put you first, and to help to always listen to your words. Talk to us now, Father, because we are listening. We ask this in the name of Jesus, who taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And to lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory forever. Amen.
This year, since we couldn't have our annual outing to Silver Sands, we thought it would be fun to set a challenge for everyone who wants to take part. It's 26 miles from Polbeth Church to Silver Sands. The challenge is to get as many people as we can to our virtual picnic. How we're going to do that is I'm going to ask you all to take a note of the steps that you walk or the miles that you cycle for the full month of July. Every week you can send those in to us. The details of how to do that are on Facebook and on our website. Now we're hoping that in August we will be able to have a celebration where we will all be able to be together in some form. At that, we're going to ask you all to guess how many people we managed to get onto our virtual beach. So I'd like to see you all walking, cycling, and thinking about how many people we're going to get there. And this term at Jam Club and Sunday Club, the plan was for the children to learn all the books of the Bible. Now obviously we've not been able to be together to do this, but some of the children have learned those on their own. Now, I don't know if you know all the books of the Bible, But if you don't, this is your opportunity. I'm going to ask the boys and girls now to share with us and to name all the books of the Bible. So I hope you enjoy.
The Old Testament. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy.
History, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1 Samuel, 2 Samuel, 1 Kings, 2 Kings, 1 Chronicles, 2 Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther.
Job, Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Solomon.
Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, Job, Amos, Obadiah.
Prophets. Isaiah, Jeremiah, Lamentations, Ezekiel, Daniel, Hosea, Job, Amos, Obadiah, Jonah, Micah, Nahum, Habakkuk, Zephaniah, Haggai, Zacharias, Malachi.
New Testament. Matthew, Mark, Luke, John. Acts. Romans, Corinthians, 1 Corinthians, 2 Galatians.
Letters. Ephesians, Philippians, Colossians, 1 Thessalonians, 2 Thessalonians, 1 Timothy, 2 Timothy, Titus, Philemon.
Letters. Hebrews, 1 Peter, 2 Peter, 1 John, 2 John, 3 John, Jude. Prophecy. Revelation.
Even tells me this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Let all ones do me wrong, they are weak, but he is strong.
Yes, he assures me. Yes, he assures me. Yes, he assures me. The Bible tells me.
I'd like to talk to you about the Bible. The Bible is an amazing book. A book like no other. It's been written and put together thousands of years ago. And people still read it today. All over the world, as a matter of fact, as the whole Bible's been translated into 698 different languages. And the New Testament's been translated into 1,548 languages. Wow. To be honest, I didn't even know that there was that many languages in the world. Now, as the young people in our congregations explained to you earlier, there are two main sections to the Bible, the Old Testament and the New Testament. In the Old Testament, there are 39 different books or chapters, and in the New Testament, 27. And together, these 66 chapters, in a way, are completely different books, all under the same cover. There are so many different genres in the Bible. There are poems and songs, serious bits and funny bits, love stories, adventure, history, rules, philosophical discussions. Think of it and you'll find it there. Now I know that you might think that a book this old would end up in a museum somewhere, gathering dust on the cover. But no, the absolute opposite is true. This is no old-fashioned book filled with boring details. For instance, in the Bible, there is a story about an ordinary girl who became a beautiful princess, who then made the king eat out of her hand, and in this way, she saved all her people. Now, doesn't that sound very much like a fairy tale? And then you can also read about giants and flying horses and a fire-breathing dragon with seven heads. How's that for adventure? And then in the same Bible, you can also read about the lengths God went to save us, his people. The story about the love a father has for his children. And then there's so many more amazing things to be read in the Bible. So today I decided to talk to you about just one of the interesting things we can find in the Bible. I would like to talk to you about honey. Did you know that the word honey appears in the Bible 61 times? Let's now read one of the passages in which we find the word honey.
We would like to read you a selection of verses from Psalm 19. The heavens tell the glory of God, and the skies announce what his hands have made. Day after day, they tell the story. Night after night, they tell it again. They have no speech or words. They don't make any sound to be heard. But their message goes out through all the world. It goes everywhere on earth.
The Lord's teachings are perfect. They give us new strength. The Lord's rules can be trusted. They make plain people wise. The Lord's orders are right. They make people happy. The Lord's commands are pure. They light up the way.
It is good to respect the Lord. That respect will last forever. The Lord's judgments are true. They are completely right. They are worth more than gold, even the purest gold. They are sweeter than honey, even the finest honey. They tell your servants what to do. Keeping them brings great rewards.
The psalmist says that God's word is sweeter than honey. When God led his people out of slavery in Egypt, he sent them to the land of milk and honey. John the Baptist lived in the desert and he ate locusts and wild honey. Like sweets for us today, honey was something very special for the people who lived in biblical times. They loved it. It reminded them of good times and special occasions. Please remember that they didn't have any sweeties like we have today. No sweets at all. And although I know for a fact that my two boys will think a world without any sweets is just a very, very sad place to be in, remember that they didn't know any better. For them, honey was as sweet as for us today, a wee sweet treat. So if in those days something was compared to honey, it had very positive connotations for them. In the book Judges, we read the story of Samson. Now, can you remember who he was? Samson was a very special man. His mom dedicated him to God when he was a baby. There's nothing he was afraid of. He was a very strong man. So one day, when Samson was just walking along the road, minding his own business, a fierce lion stormed him. Now, I know that if something like that happened to me, I would be super scared. But Samson wasn't. Like I said, he wasn't scared of anything. So he killed that lion with his bare hands. And then, sometime later, when he was walking along that same road again, he saw the lion's carcass lying there. And then he saw that the bees made a nest inside this carcass. So he went closer and he took some of the honey they made out and he ate it. And it was delicious. And then that gave Samson an idea. He came up with a riddle. Do you want to hear it? He said, "Out of the eater comes something to eat. Out of the strong comes something sweet." Now, can you work out what that meant? Remember, nobody he said this riddle to actually saw the lion's carcass with the honey in it. So they struggled so much, nobody could figure out what it meant. And in the end, they tricked Samson into telling them what the answer was. Do you want to hear what it was? Remember, the riddle said, out of the eater comes something to eat. Out of the strong comes something sweet. And it meant, what is sweeter than honey? What is stronger than a lion? And you know, up to this day, that expression, as sweet as honey, is used by us. Now, in my home language, Afrikaans, we say soos soet, soos stroop. And directly translated, that means as sweet as syrup. And it makes sense to connect syrup and honey in this way because syrup and honey look very similar and taste very similar too. Now, I want to ask you something. Does any of you like golden syrup? I love golden syrup on pancakes or even French toast for breakfast. Nothing can beat that. Now, I don't know how attentive you are, but have you ever bought Lyle's golden syrup? And have you noticed the picture on the tin? Have a wee look there. Have a good look. What do you see? The picture is a lion surrounded by bees. And just listen to the inscription at the bottom. It says, out of the strong come forth sweetness. Now, well, I never. Samson's riddle on a golden syrup tin. In the year 2020. How awesome is that? And there are many more fun and interesting things that we can read and find out about in the Bible. We call the Bible God's Word because through the words in the Bible, God speaks to us today. God's Word is as sweet as honey. It'll cheer you up when you feel down. It will give you renewed energy when you are tired. it'll never cease to amaze you. And you know, no matter how many times you read the same story in the Bible, you will always find something new and meaningful there. Very often, exactly what you needed to hear. Because you know, when we read the Bible, something very special happens to us. God's Spirit opens our eyes and our hearts so that we can hear exactly what God wants to tell us. So this summer, why don't you try to read a whole book in the Bible? I guarantee you, you will not be disappointed. If you thought eating sweeties was fun, wait till you've discovered a taste for the Bible. God speaks to us through the Bible. So let's make sure to listen to his words and see how that changes our lives for the better. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord God, we thank you for the world you created, the trees, the flowers, the rivers, the seas, the mountains, and for all its beauty. Lord God, we thank you for books, big books, little books, paperbacks, novels, and picture books. Thank you for the gift of reading and for giving us your amazing book, the Bible, which tells us of your love and other wonderful things to help us in our lives. Father God, when we think of the church, we think of our own buildings, our own friends, those who worship with us, even though we can't be with them. Lord, when you see the church, you see Christians in every country spread across the world. Lord, help us to see how great the church is, and to be glad that we belong to your family. We also pray for people who help us in our lives too, for doctors and nurses, and all who help in hospitals and care homes, and those who help with the care of people in our communities. Thank you for policemen and policewomen who keep us safe, for firemen and firewomen for their courage and their constant care. Thank you for our parents and teachers who give their time so that we may learn. Thank you for those who are just loving people, who help out when they can, and for people at church that we can go to them for help when we are troubled. Bless the leaders of the world today. Give them wisdom and understanding and the courage to say what they think is right. Help them in their decisions so that this world in which we live can have peace and we can share and provide food and medicines to people who have none. Lord God, there are so many lonely people in the world. Some of them are our neighbours, people of all ages, young and old. Help us to look out for anyone who may need friendship and think what we can do for them. Loving God, we pray for those people who we know are sick, at home or in hospital. We ask that today each of them would be aware of your love for them, and that they would turn to you for strength to face their sickness. Help them not to be unhappy because they are unwell, but to learn something special about you during this time. Please, God, comfort those who are sad and grieving, and those who just don't know which way to turn. Give them courage to keep going, although everything seems to be hopeless. Lord, when things go wrong, it is then we realise we need you. You are our hope and strength. We pray that in their troubles and sadness, more and more people will come to know your love and peace. loving God, guide us, teach us and strengthen us, so that we become gentle and kind like you, and can work for you to tell everyone about how wonderful Jesus is and the amazing stories in the Bible. Loving God, we ask you hear these our prayers in Jesus' name. Amen.
Before we conclude our service today, I would just like to make a few special announcements. A few of the boys and girls here at the West Kirk of Calder and Paul Beth Harwood Church will be going to Primary 1 after the summer. So Brooklyn, Grace, Hendrik and Noah, I would just like to wish you all an amazing time at school. I know you will have lots of fun and I can't wait to share this new exciting part of your journey through life with you. And then we also have quite a few P7s who will be moving up to high school after the summer. Andrew, Aaron, Elsha, Harris, Lucas, Olivia, Oliver, Philippa and Sam. I want to wish you God's richest blessing on your high school careers. And I would like to remind you boys and girls that although you are going to different high schools, please remember that you are never alone. God always go with us wherever we go. Thank you for playing such an important part in our church life while you were in primary school. And I know that all of you will be amazing teenagers at our church while you're in high school. And then I would just also like to say goodbye to the Van Skalkwyk family in West Kirk of Calder. Johan, Tasha, Renee, Carla and Elsha, it was so nice to have you in our congregation for almost a year. You've not been with us long, but you've made a huge impact on our congregation. Thank you for working so hard, for being so kind and friendly. We'll really miss you and we wish you God's richest blessing on this new chapter in your lives at the east coast of Scotland. We hope you'll be really happy there and please remember that you're more than welcome to come visit us here in West Calder at any time. Let us now conclude our service this morning by singing Give Me Oil in My Lamp. Thank you so much for joining Alison, Katrina, myself, and the young people from our congregations in worship today. I hope that you'll all have an awesome week filled with special sweet things. Receive the blessing of God and go in peace. The blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be with you all and with all whom you love on this day and forevermore. Amen.